Hello everyone, welcome back to Sulekha Physics classes. Hope you all are doing well. Today I am going to start class 11th physics with chapter 2, that is units and measurement. Right? This chapter is little bit easy and also very important for class 11th and 12th physics. You must have a good knowledge, good understanding of this chapter to develop a strong base in physics, right? So let us start with today's lecture. As the chapter name suggests, units and measurement. First thing comes in mind that what is this measurement? Why measurement is necessary, right? Now, so first, okay, suppose I have this marker and what is the property of this marker? How can you say how much is length, breadth or anything which shows its property? So to measure, to know the property of anything, anything means those things which can be measured, any physical quantity, right? So measurement is tells us about the property of anything. Anything means anything, any physical quantity. Measurement tells about the property of that physical quantity, right? It means with the help of measurement, you can convert this physical quantity into some meaningful numbers, right? And how you convert into meaningful numbers, you need some measuring instruments like scale. And with the help of a scale, you can measure the length of this marker. So measuring instruments is necessary, and measuring instruments are different. Like if you want to measure weight of anything, you want one weighing machine. Want to measure time, you need one stopwatch, right? Now, in the same way, if you want to measure the temperature of any body, you need one thermometer. So there are different measuring instruments with the help of which you can measure anything, and measurement is required to tell about the property of that physical instrument. Measurement gives some meaningful numbers which shows the property of that instruments, right? That physical quantity. So how can you define measurement, right? Suppose I have this marker. This is a marker, right? This is a marker. And I take one scale. Suppose this is a scale, right? This, with the help of this measuring instrument scale, you can define the property of this marker, that how much is the length of this marker, what is the breadth of this marker, right? Now, so this marker is unknown magnitude. What is this? This one is unknown magnitude. I don't know about this magnitude of this marker. And this scale is known fixed standard, right? This is known, you know. What is 1 meter, 1 centimeter, right? Now, and this marker is unknown quantity. So measurement is nothing but it is process of comparison of a known fixed standard with this unknown quantity. With the help of this fixed standard, you can compare the length of this unknown magnitude, that it is itna times smaller than this one, it this much times larger than this 1 meter, right? Now, suppose the length of this marker is 2 centimeter, right? Now, so 1 centimeter is fixed, you know, 1 centimeter, it does not change, it is fixed and internationally accepted by throughout the world, right? Now, so 1 centimeter, you know, so can you say that it is 2 times of that 1 centimeter. So it is nothing but a process. Measurement is process of comparison of a known fixed standard with an unknown magnitude, right? Any physical quantity you can compare with this fixed standard. So to know the property of anything, you need measurement, right? So for measurement, you require 2 things. One is this scale. This scale is what? Fixed standard, right? And with the help of this scale, you can measure this unknown quantity, that is marker. So you need one known fixed standard and another one is unknown magnitude, with help of which anything is measured, right? Now, What is this known fixed standard? I told you know that 1 meter, 1 centimeter is known fixed standard, that is called unit. So what is unit? Unit is the reference standard in terms of which any physical quantity can be measured. Suppose this marker and the length of this marker, if you say that the length is 1, is there any meaning? 1, is there any meaning? 5, is there any meaning? No, na? Unless and until you put some unit here, fixed standard, with the help of which you compare this unknown magnitude, right? Na? So, this unit is a fixed standard in terms of which any physical quantity can be measured, like the length of this marker is 5 centimeter. So this centimeter is what? Fixed standard. This is called unit, with the help of which anything can be measured. And so you can also say that unit is symbol of a standard value, fixed value. Unit is just a symbol, right? For example, kilogram. Kilogram is the unit of which physical quantity? Mass. Kilogram is the unit of mass. Meter is the unit of length. Second is the unit of time. These units are fixed standard, right? Now with the help of which any physical quantity can be measured. I will discuss unit first. I'm going to discuss about physical quantity. What is this physical? Because here this physical quantity terms comes now. So first you know what is physical. You must know what is this physical quantity. I'm telling you about this physical quantity, marker. Marker is that quantity which can, the length of which can be measured. So physical quantity is anything that can be measured directly or indirectly. For example, directly means with the help of a measuring instrument, like if you want to measure the length of anything, you need one scale. If you want to measure the weight of anything, you need one weighing machine. Right? If you want to measure time, you need one stopwatch like this one. So any physical quantity that can be measured directly or indirectly. Indirectly means if you want to measure the distance between sun and earth, you have to apply some indirect method. Directly you can't measure with the help of a scale or inch tape, na? You need indirect method. So directly or indirectly, anything which can be measured is called physical quantity. It means, for example, length, mass, time, area, volume of this room, all these are physical quantity. Non-physical quantity, those quantity which cannot be measured. Those physical quantity which cannot be measured, right? Now, for example, love, emotion, can you measure it in terms of numbers? No. Number of stars, that is also non-physical quantity. Number of air, all these are non-physical quantity. Now, if you measure any physical quantity, like the length of this marker is 2 centimeter, you need two things. 2 is what? 2 is magnitude. It represents magnitude. And meter is what? Unit. So to represent any physical quantity, you need two things. One is numerical value, magnitude, and another one is unit. So I will discuss that one. First, to take a screenshot of this one first. Now, representation of physical quantity, you can say symbol of physical quantity. When you measure any physical quantity, how you represent? Suppose the length of this marker is what? 1 meter. So 1 is its numerical value, it represents magnitude, and meter represents unit. So any physical quantity can be represented as numerical value into unit. For example, 1 meter, 2 kg, right? Now these 1 and 2 represents numerical value. Numerical value means it represents magnitude. It just represents magnitude, right? And this meter kg is its unit. So you can write physical quantity as n into u. N is numerical value, u is unit, and this n into u is always constant. How? Suppose the length of anything is 1 meter, and if you convert this 1 meter into centimeter, it becomes 100 centimeter. And this meter is its larger unit and centimeter is its smaller unit. When you convert this meter into centimeter, right, a smaller unit, units decreases, but this numerical value increases, right? Here numerical value is 1, here 100. So when unit decreases, its numerical value increases. But the it both represents 1 meter 100 centimeter represents the same physical quantity. You can say that it is of 1 meter length or 100 centimeter. Both represents the same physical quantity. Physical quantity is same. Both are equal. But if magnitude, if unit decreases, its magnitude increases, it means N1 U1 equal to N2 U2. Both represent the same physical quantity, right? It means the product of this N and numerical value and unit is constant. It means N is inversely proportional to U. If unit increases, N decreases. If unit decreases, here centimeter decreases from meter to centimeter, its numerical value increases. These are inversely related to each other, not direct, indirect relation. You can write here indirect relation. Direct, indirect, no, no. Direct relation means if one increases, other thing also increases. But indirect means if one increases, other quantity decreases. So inversely related to each other, right? So this is how you represent any physical quantity. Now there are different types of physical quantity. First one is fundamental, or you can say base physical quantity. Second one is derived physical quantity. And third one, actually there are only two types. This third one comes under this fundamental quantity, that is called supplementary quantity. Now what is this fundamental or base quantity? Those quantities which are independent on all other physical quantity, which does not depend on any other physical quantity. For example, mass. Mass does not depend on any other physical quantity like length, time. If mass is 1 kg, it doesn't matter. It does not depend on 1 meter, centimeter, second, right? Na? So, mass is a fundamental quantity. It is, its existence is independent. Independent existence of this mass quantity. It does not depend on any other physical quantity. So those quantity which are independent on all other physical quantity, this is called fundamental or base quantity. And there are 7 fundamental or base quantity: mass, length, time, temperature, current, intensity and amount of luminous intensity and amount of substance. All these are 7 fundamental quantity. Now next one is derived quantity. What is this derived quantity? Those quantities which are dependent on fundamental quantity. There are many physical quantities which are dependent on these 7 fundamental quantity. For example, velocity. Velocity is what? Distance by time. It depends on 1 times distance and 1 times time. It depends on these 2 fundamental quantity. So this is derived quantity. It is dependent on this fundamental quantity. In the same way, acceleration, velocity by time. It depends on, again, fundamental quantity. Force, mass into acceleration. Again, it is dependent on fundamental quantity. So there are, we can derive many quantities which are dependent on this fundamental quantity. These are called derived physical quantity. And another one is supplementary quantity. Supplementary quantity, it comes under this one. There are only 2 supplementary quantities. Okay, where I have to write? Okay, from here. There are only 2 supplementary quantities. One is plane angle and another one is solid angle. There are only 2 this supplementary quantity. Now next, if there are these different types of quantities, then units are also different. The units of this fundamental or base quantity is called fundamental units. The units of this derived quantity is called derived unit, right? So next I'm going to discuss about different types of units. First take a screenshot of this one. Now types of units. Units, you know, fixed reference standard by which any physical quantity can be measured. Now there are different types of units, right? Like different types of physical quantity, in the same way different types of units. First one is fundamental or base unit. The units of all fundamental or base physical quantity are called fundamental units. And you know what is fundamental physical quantity? Which are independent on any other physical quantity. In the same way, Fundamental units are those units which are independent on all other units. Like seven fundamental quantities, in the same way there are seven fundamental units. These are seven fundamental quantities: length, mass, time, temperature, current, luminous intensity and amount of substance. Unit of this length is meter. This is symbol small m. Mass unit is kilogram, small kg. Unit of time is what? Second, small s. Temperature, unit of temperature is Kelvin and it is represented by capital K. Unit of current is ampere. Unit of luminous intensity is candela. C, capital C, small d. Right? And here ampere is denoted by capital A. And unit of amount of substance in chemistry, you know, mole, represented by mol. These are seven fundamental units. All these are seven fundamental units. Right? Now next is, second one is like derived physical quantity in the same way derived units. So derived units are those units which are derived from these fundamental units. For example, velocity. It is a derived physical quantity. What is the expression for velocity? It is distance by time. So distance is what? Fundamental physical quantity. Time is also fundamental physical quantity. Its unit is meter and unit of time is second. So meter per second. Unit of this velocity is meter per second. It is dependent on one times meter and one times second time. Na? This meter is a fundamental unit. This second is also fundamental units. So these velocity is derived from these two fundamental units, so it is a derived units, right? So the same way acceleration, it is velocity by time, it is meter per second square. Meter is also a fundamental unit. This second, 2 times second is also used here, it is also a fundamental unit. In the same way force, MA, M is kg and A is meter per second square. All these are fundamental units. So there are so many derived units which are derived with the help of these fundamental, these seven fundamental units only, right? Now after this, third one is supplementary unit. You can write this supplementary unit under this one also. There are only two supplementary physical quantities. One is plane angle, right? These are to explain here. One is plane angle and the other one is solid angle. These are two supplementary physical quantity and its unit is, unit of plane angle is radian and unit of solid angle is steradian. Symbol for radian is RAD and steradian is capital S small r. So these are about types of units. Please take a screenshot of this one. After this, we will discuss system of units, right? Now, next is system of units. What is system of units? A complete set of units which is used to measure all kind of physical quantity. If you want to measure any type of physical quantity, you have to use only these system of units. System of units is a complete set of units which is used to measure any physical quantity. There are four system of units. First one is CGS system, second one is MKS system, third one is FPS and fourth one is SI system. What is this CGS system? C for centimeter, G for gram and S for second. It means this centimeter is the unit of what? Length. Gram is the unit of mass and second is the unit of time. So you can define this way, CGS system are those system in which length is measured in centimeter, mass in gram and time in second. This system is called CGS system, right? After this, MKS system. M is for meter, K is for kilogram, S is for second. And meter is the unit of length, kilogram is the unit of mass, second is the unit of time. So MKS system is the system in which length is measured in meter, mass is measured in kilogram and time is measured in second, right? Similarly, third one is FPS system. F for foot, P for pound and S for second. Foot is the unit of length, pound is the unit of mass and second is the unit of time. It means the system in which length is measured in foot, Mass is measured in pound and time is measured in second is called FPS system. And the last one is SI. SI system is very, very important. These are used nowadays. The full form of SI is International System of Units. And this is nothing but it is modified form of this MKS system. Here, length is in meter in SI system also, mass is in kilogram SI system also, and time is in second. So this SI system is nothing but modified form of, modernized form of this MKS system. And this is internationally accepted by all over the world. It is this SI system is accepted by throughout the world. So that's why this system is very, very useful, and nowadays this system is only used rare cases. These are used villages or this one, but those system SI system is used by throughout the world. Wherever you go, always length is in meter, mass in kilogram, and time is in second. This is SI, right? International system of units. It is based on this 7 basic and 2 supplementary units. So these are about system of units, and nowadays this SI system is used. Okay students, we can take a screenshot of this one. So with this I am going to end the class. Hope you understood today's lecture. Right now, in the next video I will discuss about measurement of length, time and mass. How you measure smaller length, larger length, what are different units to measure smaller length, larger length, different methods, direct, indirect, all these we will discuss in the next lecture, right? So up to then students, please keep revising and stay tuned with this channel. Thank you.